There once was a boy named Josh, and his whole life was an entire struggle. At the age of 10, he would come home to his parents constantly fighting. He would cry himself to sleep and hide in his room. He never knew what to do. And when he turned 11, his mom got into a car accident. She was in the hospital for days, but he prayed to God because his mom brought him up to believe that God was always there, that God would take care of him and his family. So he prayed and he prayed, but a few days later in the hospital, his mom passed. He didn't know what to do. As he entered into middle school, he was constantly picked on. His dad always blamed him, said that it was his fault for his mom's death, that he would never be good enough. And then if it wasn't bad enough, he would go to school and be picked on and bullied at and told that he was an outcast and he would never fit in. And he tried and tried, but when he got into high school, he met his best friend, Jake. But in high school, he got a call one day coming home that his friend Jake had committed suicide. After that was the breaking point. Josh didn't believe in God, he didn't pray, and he didn't care anymore. He was full of anger and hatred, and he didn't see the point of believing in somebody that couldn't even save his own friend or mother. This is a story of a testimony.
Okay, I guess.
Do you want to go to church?
With me.
Why?
Huh?
Why?
Because, you know, you're my friend and all. I wonder if
No, I'm busy that day.
Okay, see you, man.
See you later.
Bye.
Bye, have a nice day.
A few years later, Josh still walked around, hatred in his heart. There was always something inside of him that made him wonder if he should turn back to God, but then he remembered all the things that happened. So he went on like that. Hey, man.
Hey.
How you been since you graduated now?
Okay, not much going on, really.
Are you still getting all depressed and stuff?
Yeah.
Have you, ever gave it any more thought about God or...
Why should I? After all the things that have happened, he couldn't even spare my mother or my friend. Why should I believe?
Well, you should still give it a chance. Jacob's really been wanting me to come to you today.
Yeah, and I disagree. Why should I? Can you answer me that?
What is...
Everything has just gotten worse and worse and worse every time I try. Finally time to stop.
Why, has your life... You said it like your life has gotten worse.
It has.
You know, well, what changed since all those things happened?
Nothing. It's just been getting
worse.
What happened
since all those things happened to you? What stopped? What changed?
Everything. Everything got worse.
What changed, though?
I stopped believing in God. Exactly. I gave up hope.
Exactly. And your life has gotten worse. Anyway, just forget it. What are you doing later?
Hanging out with Jake.
What?
Jack.
Jack, sorry. You're hanging out with him?
Yeah.
He's a bad influence.
I don't care. At least he's a good friend. He's never let me down.
Really? He's never let you down?
Yeah.
Your girlfriend
cheated. Not like God.
Your girlfriend cheated on you with him.
He didn't know it was her. She had plastic surgery before they got together.
She was the only albino in our high school class. How did he not know it was her?
She had plastic surgery.
Whatever. Don't expect your life to change if you hang out with people like him.
I don't care. God dang it! Sup, Jack? Did you get the wine or alcohol? Alcoholic wine.
Oh, you know, is that seriously how you drank?
Yeah.
You know your girlfriend?
Tiffany?
Yeah.
What about her?
She kisses great.
Dang, yeah, but Jack, I'm gonna hurt you someday. Dating little glasses.
What about him?
What's that?
It's in a bank. Nobody was using it.
Jack! Why? You're gonna make me a criminal for life!
Nobody was using it.
That's $5 million!
Nobody was using it!
Cause they put it in there for storage, Jack!
Nobody uses it, I take it. You don't understand, I wanted it more than that.
You need to get off that alcohol.
I poured this down your shirt.
You need to get off of that alcohol.
Waitress!
Waitress! Yeah. Woman!
Whatever. I ain't paying.
Oh!
Dude! Pay.
What the heck?
Hey, you gotta pay for that. Dude!
Down.
How am I supposed to calm down when you almost got me arrested?
You're the bartender. You want on a date.
That doesn't matter. Did you realize you're drinking? You're gonna get arrested for public intoxication.
Whatever. Stop making up words.
I'm not.
Yeah, you are. You know that's not a secret, right?
Really, you should stop drinking. You're gonna get in trouble by the popo.
Hey, will you hold this for me?
No.
Can't believe you got us in jail.
Hey.
And don't talk to me.
Think about it as a sleepover at my house, only with more stone, colder, and colder.
And with iron bars for windows?
Yeah.
Talk to me.
Don't worry. Let's pretend it's my house and everything will be okay.
I'm sorry, but I can't be your friend anymore. And when I get out of here, I'm gonna tell the police everything you did.
Good for you. They'll never believe you. Night.
I'm an eyewitness.
And I'm your mom.
Josh, you're free to go. Thanks. But wait, what about him? We found out everything that he's been doing.
Don't worry about me, bro. I'm all right.
Have fun riding.
Raven. Now, to deal with you, you're staying here for life until you're dead.
He left his wallet.
Might as well try. Dear God, if anything, show me if you want me, if you want to be back in my life, that's okay. And show me a sign or something. Have a friend come over and talk about you, Lord, and that you want me in your life. Oh my gosh!
What?
Well, I took your advice. I did a little prayer to say if he wanted you to come back into my life, send you over and invite me to church, and here you are. Invite me to church.
I told you.
You know, you were right. That kid, that guy I was hanging out with, he got me put in prison for a day.
Jail?
Same thing.
Yeah, go you.
Let's go.
Where?
Church. Then again, I don't think there's gonna be much room for me. I got a criminal life. Apparently now I do.
You're criminal actually record. Gonna go to church?
Yep. Haven't gone in about who knows how long. since I was 10. Or 13.
Come on, let's go. You need Jesus. So, how'd you like church?
It was okay, it's pretty good.
So, you feel different now?
Maybe a little, yeah.
Well, it doesn't make being a Christian doesn't make it easier, but at least it gives you a source of strength.
Yeah, a chance of redemption.
And you know God will always be there in the end.
You'll never be lonely. He'll always be with you.
Yep. So now you can start your life as a Christian.
Have you always wondered who that guy was walking around?
What?
Who?
Who was that?
Jack?
The moral of this story?
No wonder he's been following me around.
Yeah!
No! Come on, Zach!
Oh, no, not again!
Come on!
Come with me! It's raining!
Well, it's nice to know something never changes.